Ubuntu Core itself has been around for a very long time, first coming out in 2014, a fully snap-based Ubuntu system for servers and IoT use cases, a minimal, secure, strictly confined operating system. Everything, even down to the kernel, is a snap. And if needed, supports automatic rollback functionality. Now, you may recall a few months back, I reckon, there was another thing announced called Ubuntu Core Desktop, which takes that concept and expands it out to be usable as a desktop operating system. So it has all of the benefits of Ubuntu Core: security, stability, reproducibility, manageability, with some added challenges like quite a bit of additional storage used, but you have basically an atomic snap-based system. Now, I have a lot of issues with snaps and don't want them anywhere near my system, and I'm sure a lot of you might feel the same way as well. But that doesn't mean this space should be left entirely open just to Ubuntu. So at Akademy 2024, Kevin Ottens held a talk titled "The Road to KDE Neon Core." Gosh, we're surrounded by snaps everywhere. Like with all of the other talks happening at Akademy, this is something that is just being worked on. It is a proof of concept. It is not a guaranteed direction things are going, and Neon isn't going anywhere anyway. So let's talk about Neon Core. Much like Ubuntu Core, it provides all of those same benefits. So security, reproducibility, manageability, you heard the spiel before. Following a very similar architecture to what Ubuntu Core Desktop is using. I'll be talking more about the architecture in just a moment, as it needs to do a couple of weird things to make it actually work. Now, obviously, instead of providing a GNOME experience, it would provide a Plasma experience, and much like Neon, provides the latest and greatest KDE software. As you may have heard in another video about a KDE OS being called KDOS, latest isn't always greatest. Sometimes there are regressions, sometimes things just don't make sense to run the newest thing, but this isn't trying to solve that issue. This is just trying to provide a full snap-based Plasma experience, with everything being provided as a snap. The desktop, the applications, the kernel, everything. This is a fully snap-based system. So this picture right here lays out what the architecture is supposed to look like. Everything that is in orange is being reused from the Ubuntu Core Desktop project. Everything blue is new and coming from KDE Neon Core. And that's because a lot of stuff just frankly doesn't need to change. The kernel is gonna work the same way. Snapd is gonna work the same way. Things outside of the Plasma suite or outside of the GNOME suite like Firefox are gonna work the same way. Core libraries like Cups and BlueAs and things like that, no issue there. All of that can just be reused. Now, every so often you might notice a 22 being used. That's because this system isn't based off of Ubuntu Core 24, it's still based on 22. That's because the project started before 24 came out, and for the sake of the discussion, has not yet been updated. So the way this system works, let's talk about that. Up the top, we have our application snaps, like Eliza, Ocular, Kwrite, things like that. These rely on a content snap known as KF6 Core 22, the content snap providing things like Qt and the KDE framework's runtime. Now, below that, we have the Plasma desktop session. This isn't the Plasma desktop, this is an intermediate snap that contains the interfaces for the applications to interact with the desktop. This needs to be here because when you have everything as a snap, there is a lot of things that just don't work out of the box like you would expect. Where the desktop comes from is the Plasma Core 22 desktop. This is the base snap. This also contains the rest of the base system. For the binaries inside the base snap, these are coming directly from KDE Neon. This just makes sense because it already has up-to-date KDE software anyway, so it might as well just be used. The applications, on the other hand, and the content snap it relies on, those are being built directly from source. Now, a lot of the talk spends time on the extreme technicals of how to make this system work, like how to make a snap, how to specifically snap plasma stuff, how will this system fit together, all these little details to make it work. And honestly, the speaker does a much better job than I could with that, so I'll leave the full talk linked in the description down below. Instead, I would like to jump ahead to the challenges. Black screens both with and without application confinement, applications not being started, applications starting, but not doing what they should be doing. Now, application issues are fairly easy to iterate. You push a change, you update the snap, and you're good to go. Plasma desktop session issues are fairly easy as well. You just log out of the system, log back in, and you reload the snap. Snapd is also relatively easy as well. Because it's such a low level component, this does require a reboot, but it's still okay to iterate on. But when there are issues in the Plasma Core 22 desktop, the thing that actually has Plasma inside of it, this requires regenerating a whole new image, which makes testing the system very, very difficult when it's still in production. Also, currently, for a fairly good reason, Snapd doesn't let snaps start up systemd unit files. There is an interface to make this happen. It has been submitted to the Snap project, but due to it not being merged, the project has to rely on a slightly modified version of Snapd. And as this is a requirement for the Plasma desktop session from earlier, this snap cannot be published on the Snap store yet. So if they're using the desktop session like they need to use for this system, it requires manual connection to the interfaces, making it a less than useful, less than nice user experience right now. Now, the project is very early on, and there is some preliminary work being done moving the system up to Ubuntu Core 24, but this is waiting on KDE Neon to also move up to a newer version of Ubuntu, which Neon always sticks with the LTS and takes a bit of time to move, so it'll happen. Now, also with this move, it comes with a change to the Ubuntu Core desktop architecture to be more modular. This also means the architecture from earlier is also subject to a lot of change, and because this version isn't done and ready yet, there is a couple of questions about exactly how things should be structured. How should it be fit into this new modular approach? The approach is probably a better way to do it and does mean that there's a lot more stuff shared with Ubuntu Core Desktop, but it's still going to cause some challenges. Through this whole process, a number of lessons have been learned. Most notably, being such a new project, not Ubuntu Core, but Ubuntu Core Desktop, it is in a constant state of flux. Between two major versions, it might just have a completely different architecture because Canonical isn't entirely sure how it's supposed to work. And being in constant flux, that architecture isn't always necessarily very well documented, or the documentation might be a bit out of date and refer to the prior architecture. It is just a bit of a mess. Also, having to rely on the rules of the Snap Store does tend to hold things back, as you need to convince people who are not using the system that you're using that something in your additional thing that only makes sense on your system is actually valuable. Also, double and triple check that things are actually being confined. Now, I would highly recommend you go and actually watch the full stream, because the speaker goes into a lot of additional details and things that I just didn't think were that important about just explaining what the system is, but it explains more about how everything fits together, all the snap stuff, how snaps work, and all that fun stuff. So if you want to go listen to that, again, it'll be linked in the description down below, and the slides are basically just university lecture slides, because the speaker does have a PhD, so this is obviously the kind of slides they're going to make. So anyone who's been to university before is going to feel very much at home, whether or not you want to be there. So let me know your thoughts about this system down below. Do you think a KDE Neon Core makes any sense? Do you think it's a waste of effort? I would love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And maybe there should be a cosmic core. Nah, it's a waste of effort.